husband bought me a WWF belt. I keep it proudly on my dresser because it was Sable kept me from.
She's a ladies' champion.
Sable kept me from becoming the ladies' champion at a minimum of 3 times by not appropriately carrying herself as a champion to defend the belt. She, the 3 times she was supposed to be dropped to me officially, she didn't bring her gear and or the belt to the building.
Get the flavors.
Okay, do we want to talk about Sable? Do we want to talk about the fact that I had a...
There's a Sable on leash tape right behind us.
Baby girl, I loved you at one time. I don't know what happened.
What will this do for you, huh?
Well, let me go back to Sable. We were in, I believe, Hamilton, Ontario. I was working with Dustin Rhodes as Gold Dust. She was working with Mark Merrill. And there were not many people in the place. It was during a blizzard, and I said, Mark, I'm going to have some fun with Sable tonight. And Sable really didn't work too much outside the ring, and Luna's character, she enjoys having a good time. So I just started messing with her, and we ended up in the ring at the end of the match and having the guys pull us apart and stuff, and Sable went with it great, and I took good care of her. She never got hurt or anything, and the agents liked it so much, they said at the next TV, do it for Vince, so we did it with a big pull apart and everything, and from there, Sable became a lady wrestler. It ended up where we were going into a WrestleMania, and I told Sable, they want us to do this match. We've done the pull apart all around the country, cat fighting and getting to each other, and it was going real well. And so we started working out in the ring, and I said, I want you to learn to distribute your weight so that you don't hurt yourself. That if you don't learn to distribute your weight properly by taking your bumps properly, you're liable to get hurt. Well, we went around, and I was pretty much getting a little choreographed piece of this WrestleMania match down with her because she
even
wasn't
thought of a WrestleMania. What, it was just a tease, though.
Well, at 6 weeks out from WrestleMania.
Oh, okay. You know, so you passed all the others.
Right. And,
I'm just trying to keep track. I got lost. If you lost, I'm on.
She went. But I kept saying on our days off, we need to go to Stanford. And you need to, instead of just working out for the half hour before the show starts in the different towns we were in, we need to go to Stanford and teach you to take bumps. And she eventually came to me and said, things were getting real mysterious. We went from being real good friends where, oh, Luna, thank you so much, and her being very respectful and showing old school respect to me that I was taking care of her, to her believing that she was everything that the fans made her think she was, because I was letting her, I was taking all the bumps for her. I was letting her beat the hell out of me, and I like it like that. Whatever, go ahead, give it to me. We went from being the best of friends till things started feeling like there was some sneakiness going on. And I like to believe at that point, well, I'm being paranoid. But then she came to me when I said, we must get to Stanford. You must learn to take bumps. It's imperative that you learn how to protect yourself. And she said, I don't have to learn to take bumps because Vince has told me I'm going to be the women's champion. Well, to somebody that grew up thinking that all they wanted in the whole world was to be the WWF Women's Champion, it tore me apart. Here I have busted my ass. I have wrestled all over the world. I have gone against the toughest kickboxers, karate and judo. I've been suplexed off the top rope in Cork and all. I have had morphine shot into my knee in Japan to get me to go to the ring. And you don't have to learn to take bumps.